Hey guys, this is StudyTime's Level 2 strategy video for algebra, and I'm Mackenzie.
I'm Hattie.
And we're going to be giving you all the tips you need to help get you through.
This paper basically assesses you on all the main skills from algebra, but more than that, your ability to apply them to new, unfamiliar situations. This can feel a bit daunting, but with a good grasp on the basics and with a few tips and tricks from us, you'll be well set up for success. The most important thing to remember is that everything you've learned in this paper is built on what you've learned in years before. So ever since you first encountered algebra, you've been building up the skills to ace this paper. If you're still feeling a bit shaky about last year's content, we'd recommend going back through some old textbooks before moving on to Level 2 content.
The good news is, once you have these basic skills down, getting excellence in the standard isn't actually too difficult. In a given exam, you have roughly 8 opportunities to get a question up to excellence, and you only need a minimum of 3 of these to actually get an overall excellence. So looking at those probabilities, it isn't too bad.
First off, the questions won't necessarily be in order of difficulty like you might be used to. In some past year's papers, the first question on the exam has been extra difficult, which has stressed a lot of students out. If this happens to you, try not to panic, stay calm and move on to the next question. If you have extra time at the end, you can always come back to that question you skipped. Another mistake to avoid is being too positive. If you're adding or subtracting fractions that have negative signs in, when you're rearranging, you need to make sure that you're expanding out that negative sign. This is a really common mistake that students make, and it can cost you quite a few marks.
When dealing with indices, remember that our index rules are only applied to exponents. Regular numbers, or coefficients of variables, we deal with in the exact same way that we've always been taught to. For example, in this problem, our index rules tell us to times our 2s together, but 5 is squared, so we should really answer the question like this.
Don't just bring your calculator into the exam. Make sure that you're using it every single time you revise or do work in maths class. It's going to be a major advantage to you if you're really quick and reliable using the different modes of your calculator. That being said, don't forget everything you learned in the MCAT last year. Being able to actually do those algebraic manipulations by hand will let you know if the answer you're getting on your calculator actually makes sense. Another tip is to know the values of common powers, like 2 cubed or 3 cubed. It's not that you need to calculate these in the exam, because you'll have your calculator. It's more that it's really helpful to you to be able to notice them. For example, if you had this question, knowing that 5 to the power of 3 is the same as 125 would make the question way easier.
Quadratics is a topic that pops up every year, so be sure that you're comfortable with the quadratic formula and you know how to use it accurately. You will be given it in an exam, but don't rely on this completely. You do have to have some background knowledge of how to appropriately use it. Secondly, make sure that you're comfortable with a couple different formats of quadratic equations, because these also do come up. And being comfortable with how to form an equation based off of a graph is also a really key skill.
When you're looking at a long word question, the first thing to do is to identify what kind of answer you're looking for. It might be something like a number of days, or it might be a yes or no with a justification. Write this down at the bottom of your answer space immediately, so that when you finish writing your answer, you'll know that you've given the marker exactly what they were looking for. Next, go through the question and break down the information you're given line by line. NCEA won't give you any information that you don't need in the question, especially not numbers. You know that you'll use every single one. Do be aware though that in multiple part questions, a number might not be used in the first part and might be useful later on.
Another really common question is to find the border or the area of a specific shape. It can be useful to break this down into different areas and then adding it all up together in the end. For example, if you wanted to find what the inside of a picture frame was, you could set up an equation like this. The inside of the frame equals the total area minus the frame. Also, if you have a question that uses things like tunnels or bridges that leans towards a parabola, it can be really useful to graph this using the x-axis or your roots as your ground level. Finally, right at the end, make sure that you're putting all your answers back into the context of the question that you were given.
When it comes to the actual exam, if you do get stuck on a particularly hard question, don't panic. It's probably hard for everyone, and you're not meant to be able to answer everything completely perfectly. Try to take a step back and identify what concepts they're asking you to use. It might be a combination of quite a few, but it will always come back to the same basic ideas. Things like factorizing, simplifying, expanding. Nothing has changed. Don't let the more abstract questions put you off either. They use exactly the same skills as more numerical questions. If you still have no clue where to start, a good thing to do can be to look back on other parts of the question. So say if you were stuck on question 2D, you'd want to have a look back on questions A, B, and C to see if you could find any hints about what to do. Sometimes the questions are grouped to use similar skills, although this isn't always the case.
So guys, this has been StudyTime's Level 2 strategy video for algebra.
We've walked you through a lot of tips, but we haven't covered everything. We'd really recommend checking out the past 3 or 4 years of exam papers to get a feel for what to expect, and also having a look at the StudyTime walkthrough guides, which are available for free online or to purchase in print with next day delivery. They're designed to walk you through the entire concept and get you really familiar with everything you need to know.
Thanks for watching, guys, and good luck for your exams.